heat from fire and fire from heat. My name is Lorraine Perkins. I'm a transgender person, and I'm here to testify against SB 12, SB 1601, and any future anti-trans, queer, or other LGBTQIA legislation that comes before this body. I have appeared before the city council, but this is my first time that I've graced this chamber with my presence, so my voice may be shaky, my hands may be trembling, but it is not out of fear or trepidation, but out of indignation and righteous anger. I've been graciously provided by this body a mere 2 minutes to plead the case for my humanity. This morning, I spent not an inconsequential amount of time pondering what to wear, how to do my makeup, what I should sound like, how I could best present myself to make my humanity clear and obvious to this committee. Isn't that a shame? In reality, it should be obvious that I'm deserving of the same rights and privileges afforded everyone else. By hiding your bigotry behind children like cowards, you will find yourself on the wrong side of history. By manipulating the words of an ancient text and shoehorning it into legislation aimed at an at-risk minority population, you liken yourselves to another group that gained popularity in Germany in the 1930s. If you have ever wondered what you would have done had you been a member of the so-called greatest generation, then simply look around to what you are doing in this moment. When a small man with a smaller mustache stood before crowds and proclaimed himself superior to others, I see you here doing the same. The first books that the Nazi Party burned were those of Magnus Hirschfeld and the Institute of Sexual Health. Some of the first imprisoned under the Nazi Party rule were homosexual and transgender people. Likely the first woman to undergo a successful gender reassignment surgery was killed in that same prison. When those prison camps were freed by the Allies, we were the ones who were still kept in prison for our so-called crimes. For loving who we love, and for living our truth. We can see through this veneer of legislation and assess the intended target. The continued marginalization and othering of the LGBTQIA+ community. Rhetoric intended to strike fear into the hearts of the people of this city. I will not sit here and debate your fascist ideology, as peddlers of intolerance deserve no such stage on a public forum. I will not appear for linoleum, tax base of jobs or business growth in this state. They are inconsequential in the recognition of the basic rights of your fellow human.
Thank you for your testimony.
The bill is 2 seconds away from the outdated discriminatory three articles laws of the 20th century, and I will not stand for it. We will not stand for it. We may not win today, and we may not win tomorrow, but we will persist as we always have the fight of your oppression.
We'll be right back.
risk of suicide goes way up. Well, I am one of those parents who lived with a daughter who was suicidal for 3 years. Someone once asked me, wouldn't I just do anything to help save her? And I really had to think. And the answer was, no.
We'll be right back. should be ashamed. If you vote yes on this bill and yes on these amendments, I hope the next time there's an invocation, when you bow your heads in prayer, you see the blood on your hands.
Planet Earth that are happy to display themselves as if they were mutants from another planet. This is the planet Earth, where God created men, male, and women, female. I'm a proud Christian conservative Republican. I'm not on the fence. Not on the fence. There is so much darkness in our world today. So much evil in our world today. And so many people who are afraid to address the evil, the dysphoria, the dysfunction. I'm not afraid to address the dysphoria or the dysfunction. The Lord rebuke you, Satan, and all of your demons and all of your imps who come and parade before us. That's right, I called you demons and imps who come and parade before us and pretend that you are part of this world. So I'm saying my righteous indignation is stirred. I am sick and tired of this. I'm not going to put up with it. You can test me and try to take me on, but I promise you I'll win every time.
elected me to be their representative in the People's House. Today, I rise in defense of those constituents, of my community, and of democracy itself. Last week, I spoke on the governor's amendments to Senate Bill 99, which banned gender-affirming care. This was a bill that was one of many targeting the LGBTQ community in Montana. This legislature has systematically attacked that community. We have seen bills targeting our art forms, our books, our history, and our healthcare. And I rose up in defense of my community that day, speaking to harms that these bills bring and that I have firsthand experience in knowing about. I have had friends who have taken their lives because of these bills. I have fielded calls from families in Montana, including one family whose trans teenager attempted to take her life while watching a hearing on one of the anti-trans bills. And in that hearing, our caucus pleaded with the Republican chair of the Judiciary Committee to not allow certain testimony to keep decorum. And we were told a lot of people have a lot of opinions on these things. So when I rose up and said, there is blood on your hands, I was speaking to the real consequences of the votes that we as legislators take in this body.
Let her speak.
And when the speaker gaveled down the people demanding that democracy work, demanding that their representative be heard, when he gaveled down, what he was doing was driving the nail in the coffin of democracy. But you cannot kill democracy. And that is why they kept chanting. And why I raised my microphone to amplify their voices. Make sure that the people who elected me here are heard. And that when this body seeks to pass bills that harm the people, that this body is held accountable for those actions.
Joy that has been forever. It is our love that has been forever.